Hi, it's Renata here. If it's your first time here, welcome to my channel, The Quantic Girl, where we are going to talk about some topics in quantitative finance, in pure and applied mathematics, in programming, especially in Python program, and in financial markets in general, because I'm a PhD in mathematics and a financial quantitative analyst. And I'm here to share with you some of my experience. Today, we are going to code in Python, a very popular trading strategy in equity market, the pairs trading strategy. Our focus today is to see the simulation of the strategy, but let's talk a little about the theory. The pairs trade strategy is a form of mean reversion with the advantage of always being hedged against the movement of the market. The principle of the strategy is very simple. We have a pair of assets that are related to each other in a certain sense. For example, we could have two companies that produce the same type of product, and then we make a trade based on this relationship. The measure for which we look for when trying to identify this relationship is cointegration. In a very summarized way, without going into detail in the mathematical modeling, we are going to build a trade based on the ratio between the stock price series of two assets that are tested positive for cointegration. We then define trading signals of buying or selling the ratio based on the distance of the series from the mean. So for example, when the ratio series extrapolate one standard deviation up or down from its mean value, we define signal for enter in a position or to exit from a position. In a very summarized way, this is the pairs trade strategy. So now that we have talked a little in a very basic way about what the strategy is, let's go to the implementation. So just keep watching the video and code with me. So now let's implement our strategy in Python. The first thing that you need to do is to import the libraries that we are going to use. So let's just do it in the first cell. Okay, let's move on and define a start date and an end date to build our model, and we are going to use this list of stocks from the tech industry in order to check which pairs test positive for cointegration. And the first step is to save the closing prices for these stocks into a data frame that we are going to call here as GF. So what we have here is the closing prices for this list of stocks in the time interval we defined here. Okay, let's move on and define a function that will test for cointegration for each pair of stocks from this list of stocks. Okay, now that we have our function, let's apply it to this list of stocks in order to find which pairs test positive for cointegration.
Okay, we have that these three pairs of stocks tested positive for co-integration. So let's take the last one and check that everything is okay. Okay, so we have a p-value of less than 0.05, and so this pair of stocks tests positive for co-integration, and we are going to use this pair to build our strategy. So let's move on and take the ratio series, the ratio between the stocks prices of the two stocks of our pair that tested positive for co-integration. So we have here just the price ratio series and its mean value. Let's move on and standardize our series in order to define our trading signals. So as we talked in the beginning of this video, we are going to build our strategy based on deviations of the ratio series from its mean value. Here we are going to use one standard deviation up or down, but you could use whatever quantity of standard deviations you want. You could use, for example, two standard deviations up or down, but we made a choice here and defined our parameter as one standard deviation up or down from the mean value. Okay, we are going to split our data into training data in order to build our model and test data in order to test the model. And we are going to take 70% of our data as training data and the last 30% as test data. Okay. So now here we are going to calculate the moving average from the ratio series considering windows of 60 days and 5 days, because we are going to use these moving averages to define our trading strategy. So what we are going to use here is this series here that takes into account the difference between the two moving averages of 60 days window and 5 days window. Okay, so here we have our trading signal. So when the series extrapolates one standard deviation up, we find a sell signal, and when the series extrapolate one standard deviation down, we find a buy signal. So let's see our trading signals. So we have in red the sell signals. So when we extrapolate one standard deviation up, we define a sell signal, and in green we have the buy signals when we extrapolate one standard deviation down. Okay, so the strategy here is in terms of the ratio series. So when we buy the ratio, we actually buy stock 1 and sell stock 2, and when we sell the ratio, we sell stock 1 and buy stock 2. So let's split this information of trading signals into the two series of the two stocks that forms our co-integrated pair. So what we have here is the same information we have here, but split it into the two stocks. So when we have a buy signal in green, what we do is buy stock 1 and sell stock 2. And when we have a sell signal in red, what we do is to sell stock 1 and to buy stock 2. Okay, so now that we have modeled our strategy, so let's simulate a trade here. Let's suppose that we start with zero money and zero value in positions for stock 1 and also for stock 2. And let's see what happens in terms of P&L. Okay, so we have this P&L here, supposing we start with no money and no position in stock 2 and in stock 1 and also in stock 2 for the pair trading we used the pair that tested positive for coin integration. So that's it. That's in summary what is the pair trading strategy. We just defining buying and selling signals, looking for the deviations from the ratio series from its mean value.
That's all for today. In this video, our focus was in the implementation of the pair trading strategy, and in some video in the future, we are going to detail the mathematical modeling of the strategy. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you can know when I upload this video. Hope you like the video. Don't forget to hit the like button because it helps me a lot. And again, don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you can watch the next videos. So see you guys next time in the next video. Bye.